remembering. Because remember, we can't have the DNA moving around, so it's stuck in this nucleus. And that membrane keeps the nucleus at a certain side of the cell. And we need our DNA to be in the center, so it moves over here. The next stage, guess what's going to happen? Guess what's going to happen in the next stage?
You're going to be pulled up and it's going to separate the DNA.
Exactly. So our DNA is going to be pulled apart. What is going to facilitate this? How is this pull going to happen? We learned about it last week. How do you think this is going to happen?
The microtubules.
The microtubules?
Yeah.
So what about the microtubules?
They're going to pull chymosins, something like that.
They're going to do what?
The proteins. They're going to, the microtubules, they are bipolar, right?
Right.
They have the positive pull and the negative pull. So the positive pull is going to pull the centrifuge and towards the cell, and while the negative pull will be attached to the DNA strand. So as the kinesin pulls, then the negative pull is forced to follow, but will not leave the DNA strand that is attached to the DNA. So both of them are going to pull in opposite directions. The two central groups like what we would have to do in opposite directions.
So that's a very good way of explaining it. It's almost completely correct, except you have polarities mixed up. Because these are actually going to be our positive poles. And then on here attached to the back is where our negatives are going to be. And so on these positive poles, the DNA is actually going to get attached to some motors that are going to walk on those microtubules. Do you remember? So if this is a positive pole and this is a negative pole, what kind of motor are we going to want to attach to that?
What kind of?
A motor. It's the enzyme that walks down.
GTP.
GTP is what it uses for energy. But so we had two motors. Remember what they were?
Yeah, one.
Exactly. And so one walks towards the negative, the other walks towards the positive.